technical issues, but I think we are good now. Hi guys, how are you guys doing? Hope you are all well. Put that on the background. Should have closed my door because now I can hear Mama Blaze's TV because she has it blasting. I don't know why, she usually doesn't. I'm getting ready to film. I was supposed to film like almost a week ago, but other things were cause of my attention, everybody's attention elsewhere, so needed to be delayed until, and also I've been sick, so it's fibro flare-up season. Woo! Love that. I hate that fibro flare-up season is also coincided with, is that the right word to use for this? Coincided with my favorite time of year. I love that. It's also bipolar flare-up season. So it's great to have both of those things. I'm going to try not to complain, but I will complain during this because I always do. I go back and I watch some of my lives to see like my interactions with you guys. I love seeing interactions with you guys. And I'm like, 90% of that is complaining. Guys, tell me to stop complaining. Just be like, bitch, stop complaining. If you guys watched my, what I got from my birthday haul from this year, you guys will have seen my mother and my father, got me an Apple card, which I've already gone through. Like, I just noticed the day before yesterday when I tried to purchase something, it's like, bitch, you used up all your money on this. And I was like, damn it. With some of that money that I, got, I purchased one of my favorite albums of all time that I listened to nonstop the last 2 years of my high school year, which was Toxicity by System of a Down. I listened to it on the way to school and on the way home, the whole album, because it was an hour ride there and an hour ride home. So it means a lot to me, this album. So I downloaded the whole album. So I've just been like listening to it nonstop, and it's been giving me both anxiety and feels because like school memories give me anxiety, a lot of them, but like also it's like one of the best albums of all time. So I'm playing it again. All right, clean face with witch hazel. So when you guys join, let me know in the chat if you guys join, or I might just be talking to myself the entire time, which is very possible. I don't even know what time it is. It's 5:15 where I live. This has happened where I've just come on live and I've talked to myself, so it's very possible. If that happens, I'll just delete this. It's fine. It's fine. Everything's fine here. Everything's fine. No cause for alarm. I've been trying to write down some ideas for Blazeween this year. If you guys have any, please let me know down in the comments. But I was like looking in past years, what I did Halloween, Blazeween years, and I was looking at how heavy I was. I still am, but like how much heavier I used to be. And I cried. That's it. That's the end of that story. But you know what? I'm making changes. I'm making changes, and that's all that matters, right? All right. Back to our regularly scheduled programming. Okay. Time to prime this face. I don't think you guys are hearing what I'm saying, which is probably better. It's vulgar, so. It's just moving down, so. I don't know if I want to put on full-ass foundation or just my tinted moisturizer. I'll show you. Hi, Chloe. It's okay. Oh my god, I love this primer. This is the Revolution Makeup Revolution H2O Hydrate Primer, but like most of the time this but like it doesn't work. You see this? Nothing's coming out. So otherwise, it's a really good primer. I want to make this too loud because it's System of a Down and it gets loud. I didn't need the last part of that. It works well when it's on your face, just the pump doesn't work well. It's a good primer. The pump just... I don't like that question. But I knew it was going to come out, that somebody was going to ask, and I thank you for asking once I went live. Like, how are you? I was like, oh, I don't like that question. I'm just trying to survive. That's how I'll answer that. I'm trying to survive at this point. I think that that's the best way to answer that. How are you? I'm trying to get pumped for Halloween, spooky season. We've already done most, if not all, the decorating. Getting ready for 31 Days of Horror. I've like made sure that I've not been watching any horror or horror adjacent type movies. I've been like saving it up for all of October. And so I can have 31 days of horror like all throughout October. So like I'm jonesing for horror movies, and shows and horror adjacent movies and stuff like that. So like I'm really jonesing. But like I'm so like pumped for that. If you guys want to follow what I watch and my ratings and my opinions and everything, follow me on Instagram. I'll probably do it on my Discord this year too. I'll probably post some on my Snapchat. I'll be posting some of it on my vlogs. You guys don't know my personal Facebook. You did comment something. Let me see. For 38 weeks. Oh, congratulations. You're almost there. Are you having a boy or a girl? Do you know? Mazel tov. I think I'm just going to do the Maybelline Dream BB Fresh thing. I don't want to put on a whole cake face for this. Or should I? I don't know. What should I do? Oh, a little baby boy. Very nice. I wish you nothing but health and happiness. Kiwi, it's been a while. Haven't seen you. Yeah, I've heard that as a side effect. How are you, Kiwi? I don't know if I should just use the moisturizer or... I already put it on. No going back. I was listening to this the other day loudly in the living room. So my dad was in the basement and he was coming up and he was like going really slow with like a look in his eyes. He was like, "Are you okay?" I'm like, "Yeah, why?" And he was like, "What is this?" I'm like, "System of a Down." He was like, "Why is it so angry?" I was like, "This is my mute. Where have you been, Mike? Have you not been paying attention? It's one of my favorite bands of all time. It's like the top three. It's my life since I was a young teenager. What are you talking about? Like, this is... it's like the only kind of music I've listened to since I was a teen." He's either never paid attention my entire life, or his memory's gone. It's one of the two. Or both. I don't know. But he was like, "It's so angry." I'm like, "No, they're not angry. It's just the style of music. They're, I was like, "Do you remember when I was a young teenager and all my female and male friends, they did not discriminate even back then when it was like, guys were like, ew, I'm not gay." I'm like, shut up, guys. Shut up. Don't be like that. But like, even back, my guy friends both were like, "Dude, your dad's hot. He looks just like Serge." First of all, they were right. He did look like an older version of Serge, but please don't call my dad hot. Please don't do that. Please don't do that. I'm missing your guys' conversation, but like, he did look like Serge for a hot minute. Not a hot minute. I meant like for a minute, you know, he wasn't hot. I might have to get a blood transfusion. Oh my God. Oh, I hope everything goes okay. It's absolutely not a phase. Absolutely. What I thought it was at first, when I started, I always listened to like grunge and rock and roll, classic rock music, that genre. But like when heavy metal, besides like Metallica, I listened to when I was a kid and stuff like that, like classic heavy metal. Like that I listened to, but like when heavy new metal started becoming a thing, like Disturbed, when they came out, they were like the first band of like new metal and heavy metal and Korn. When they started coming out, like they're the ones that introduced me to that genre. Then like System of a Down, when they came out, I was like, I like this. So from then on, that was like the only type of music I listened to, and that became my world. Well, also, I don't listen to his music anymore, and he can write the hell off into hell. Marilyn Manson, I listened to. I went from, like I always say, I went from Hanson to Manson. But I did, and up until a few years ago when the allegations started coming out and everything, and we got evidence, and more than one person started coming out, he can fuck right the hell off to hell, which broke my heart. That was suck. It still is suck. I hate when your idols become awful. Just awful people. Not just people you like, idols. I idolized that man. His outfit in the Dope Show music video, since I was a kid, I was like, one day I'm gonna save up enough money to afford that outfit. Not anymore, bitch. yeah. I being a survivor myself, I mentioned this on a couple of TikToks. I had to break it in two because this was before you can do like a 3-minute video. I wanted to see him so badly too when he did the reuniting the twins, evil twins with him and Rob Zombie. Rob Zombie, I don't want to say this because like it's like you never know nowadays, and you never know, but like he seems to be like an all-around good person, but you never know. But hopefully he stays that way. They were in Denver and I wanted to go see them so bad, but that's when I had my agoraphobia and I was like, absolutely not. And that sucks. So at first I was like, no, they're just allegations. Not true. It can't be true. No, he's just a twisted, weird human, but he's not like twisted in that way. He's just weird. And then I was like, I had to like take a few days and be like, listen, you know how this is, you know how this goes. And then I listened to Evan Rachel Wood's and I listened to her story and how it was almost exactly verbatim what I went through. And my heart stopped. And I was shaking. I was having panic attacks for days. I was having nightmares reoccurring. And I was like, how can I not and I was like, how can I be an advocate for survivors of this and say, just because I idolize this man and I've loved him since I was a kid, that it's not true because I love him. That's like saying with my ex-boy, even though I didn't love him, I was like being brainwashed. That's like me with my boyfriend, my abuser all over again. Like, it's not true. You don't know what he's like. It was just a whole shit ton of emotions and I had to like recheck myself and be like, wake up. He's a horrible person. He is a scumbag. He's the lowest form of scum of the earth. And she's telling the truth because you've lived this. And she had like stories that match my experience to the T. And I'm like, she's not making this up. Because it was like very, very specific things that you don't see in Hollywood. And I'm like, there's no way she's lying. Yes, I am. Oh yeah, there are still people who are diehard fans. And not even fans at all who still say she's lying for attention. And it's also been proven that he did nothing. Where has it been proven that he did nothing? No, it hasn't. There's been a couple of cases that have been dismissed because, with Marilyn Manson, there's been a couple of his survivors and his victims that have not gone to trial because they're terrified. And there's been dismisses because there's not been it's been too long and the evidence, is gone. And that happens a lot in SA cases. Unfortunately, when victims wait too long, that the evidence it's gone and you can't do anything about it, but you can speak your truth and just get that out there. Like, he did this and speak your truth. And that's all you can do, and take your power back. That's all you can do. But there has been nothing saying he's innocent. No, nothing. There's been no proof showing that he's innocent. And I don't believe he's innocent at all. I've seen they've shown videos of him being extremely violent. With multiple witnesses showing him being extremely violent. That's one that I'm never gonna get over. Danny Masterson was not an idol. I loved him for a long time. Please don't get me started. I don't want to keep talking about this. It's making me actually a lot really anxious because it's triggering. They can all just burn in hell for all I care. Yeah. They show him backstage just like literally just like no, it's okay. Don't be sorry. The Marilyn Manson, they show him backstage just literally blowing up and for no reason. Just being himself, just like throwing things against, like breaking things against walls. And no, all they're doing is walking down the hall and just breaking things, becoming violent, hurting people for no reason. Like, I get being weird and being rebellious and like wanting to be just be quirky and weird. But like, dude, are you, who hurt you? Like, and we just made it, me included, his diehard fans made excuses for this bullshit, like for years. Just that he is quirky and weird and crazy. Yep, he was a puppet master, exactly. He played us all. That he's just quirky and weird and just like, that's just how he is. No. Yeah, that is how he is, but like violent, like actually violent and dangerous. Like dangerous, stay away from him, dangerous. Like everybody in the world, stay away from him. Oh, this is a little spoiler from one of my vlogs that you'll be seeing. It's the first vlog? Yeah, the first vlog of Blaze-a-ween. Which was a nightmare, might I add. The reason it was a nightmare was because I kept forgetting to edit some things in. So I had to keep re-editing it. And so I had to keep resaving it. And it was like a nightmare rendering it. Oh, hi, Pink. Hi, Michelle. Oh, so nice to say hi. Have a good day at work. And then I uploaded it completely to YouTube and I was like, great. So I'll delete it from my video editor. Did all that, deleted it from everything. Then I was re-watching it on YouTube to make sure everything was perfect. Even though I shouldn't have deleted it from my editor before I made sure. that everything was perfect. I shouldn't have. And then I noticed that my intro that I did was my regular intro and not my Blaze-a-ween intro. I know it's so insignificant, but my Blaze-a-ween intro is specifically for October. And I'm like, I can't use my regular intro in October. So I had to re-download it from YouTube. So the quality is not as good as my regular videos and everything. So I had to re-download it, crop everything out, re-cut so many things, and re-put the new intro in. Oh, thank you so much, Kiwi. Do you want me to call you something else besides Kiwi? I don't know. If that's pissing you off, let me know. I had to re-download it, go back to the editor. I had to cut so many things. I had to splice so many things. Splice. Ooh, I should watch that during Blaze-a-ween. I haven't watched that in a couple years. And I was just, and re-render it, re-save it, redo all the bullshit again. And I'm like, this is such a pain in the ass. This is so annoying. And I was just like, I had it. For days this was going on. And I was just like, please just let it stop. Please, 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 please. I'm done. Yeah, I got these. They now sell the little finger baby ones at Dollar Tree. Because I was like, I want to get on this trend. And I love it. I like to listen to System of a Down and hard rock and heavy metal and new metal when I'm working out, because I get angry when I'm working out because it's not done yet and I still have more to go. I get so angry when I'm working out. Does anybody else? Does Shop Miss A? I've been wanting to place another order with Shop Miss A, but I'm like, I don't know. Maybe I'll do that during Blaze Away, and I'm not entirely sure. Mama Blaze, are you here? Because your TV's off. Either she went to take a rest because she needs it. Mama Blaze has been through the ring. Yeah. I've taken a couple peeks, and I refollowed them on Instagram because I realized that was really shady, even though we had our little falling out. So I started refollowing them. It is really fucking boring now. It is really. Thank you. She's going through a lot. So thank you. Thank you for that. I'm sure she appreciates it too. Hoping that she recovers soon, because we need our Mama Blaze back. She doesn't want me to talk too much about it, but she did like have some procedure done, and that was actually a week ago, and she's on the mend, sort of. She's just, it's taking a while, so. Really? Yeah, they're not as nice and not as understanding and not as great as they were. Are you serious? That's shady. I'm not surprised though. They screwed me over big time. I understand that they say it's now like legality, but like after all I freaking did for them, they could have at least like been a little bit nicer about it, like, or more polite about it. You want me to drag them? Oh, I can drag them. I don't want to, like, go too into it, like, too detailed. Basically, I'll be, like, very, very, non-specific. Basically, I'm not an affiliate anymore because they changed their, affiliation. I don't know how to explain it. Like, their affiliation type of way of doing things. And I was trying to fill out certain things, and I told them that I'm on disability. And I couldn't fill out certain things. And they said, well, if you're on disability, you can't be an affiliate. And I said, but I've been on disability for since I was 19 years old, and I've been an affiliate with you guys this whole entire time. And they're like, yeah, well, but because of this reason, you can't be anymore. I said, but I've been an affiliate with you guys for years, and making you guys, I've been top affiliate for a year in a row. I've been making you guys business, repeat customers, like my whole fan base loves you guys, and I'm helping you guys. And they're like, we wish, and they did do the whole, we wish you well in your future endeavors, and stop talking to me. That's pretty much the tea. Yeah. Yeah. There's plenty of people who are on disability that still do work like this. So, and I was on disability when I worked for them. So, don't really get it. I'm gonna use a different blush this time around. A little bit more of a fall tone. So I don't get it. I don't get it. And I don't get why they got nasty with me and stopped talking to me when I was like, hey, I'm not done talking to you guys. I'm going to use the shade Berries instead of using Flower Child, which I usually use. BoxyCharm and Ulta are like that. I've heard some shit about BoxyCharm. I wanted to sign up for that one year as a Christmas gift, and I was like, eh. And now I'm glad I didn't, because I don't use any products with talc and mica. So, I'm not as enthusiastic about makeup as I used to be. I still like it, but like, not as much as I used to. What am I into now? Like, as hardcore as I was into makeup. I was gonna say chores. It really is. Like, I like doing things around the house. It keeps me busy. Working, like, side jobs. My side jobs that I do to make some extra money. Keeps me busy. Anything that keeps me busy and doesn't keep me anxious and thinking about things that are depressing or anxiety inducing. I like just keeping busy. I like my art. There's a trash into one of their mascaras and they said no and still gave me. What? Was that BoxyCharm that did that? My god, dude. Ow. Bristle just went into my eyeball. Ah, it sucks. This is the lazy way of not putting on any eyeshadow. Just do your blush and eyeshadow at the same time. I love thrifting and shopping, of course. But then that means you have to spend money. But at least thrifting, you don't have to spend as much money. But I love thrifting. Oh my god. I love thrifting. Oh, I didn't pick out what lashes I want to wear. Toxicity is playing now, so. If you follow me on Discord and Snapchat, you'll have seen me like at the end of my workout a couple weeks ago where I started singing that part after I was done working out. And I was like, I'm so angry. I want to punch a Republican baby. I was so angry because I was doing a workout that like I'd never done before and it was an hour long and I was like, please stop. I was like, I don't want to do this anymore, and I was just like so angry. And it's by Roberta's Gym, so like the woman in like the video or the cartoon or AI woman in the TV, her name's Roberta. So I was like, fuck you, Roberta. So I was just like so angry. I was like, first of all, suck it, and like, fuck you for making me do this. I was so angry. So I was like, it's perfect time for me to be listening to this. I'm so pissed off. Ulta stole your packages? I haven't been into an Ulta forever. Oh my god. That's terrible. Makeup companies are shady as hell. I'm telling you. They're just shady as hell. That's why I don't fuck with them anymore. Juno & Co. stopped completely communicating with all their affiliates. All of us. We all just stopped with, yeah. But, like, Juno & Co. completely stopped communicating with all of their affiliates. We were all part of, is this the, no, an app, and they were like, this is an app for the affiliates, so you guys can talk to each other and talk to the, the people, like, that run Juno & Co. So, like, we all, it was fine for, like, the first couple months, and then they started launching their Juno skin stuff. They stopped talking to us, and we were like, so what's going on? Where are you guys? Like, where's the people in charge? Are we going to be receiving Juno skin? They talked to us one more time, and they said no, because it's not part of Juno & Co. It's Juno skin. And we're like, that doesn't really make sense. We're like, affiliates, it's the same company. So we want to review it for you guys so we can help spread the word. And they stopped there completely. They stopped responding to our private messages. They stopped responding in the app. And we were going on for months. Like, where is anybody? We're just talking to our other affiliates. Like, what's going on? So we all just deleted the app off our phones and never heard from them again. Shady. Shady as yep. And now they don't even sell makeup or anything anymore. It's bullshit. Yeah, absolutely. Can't believe I worked for some of these companies. I was blinded. They treated me good sometimes, but Juno & Co.? Never paid me any commission. Never. Never. People bought with my code. They showed me. Never paid me any of my commission. Not one dime. Not one penny. Nothing. There's the tea on that. I think I've said that before, but not like I made, like, $1 million, but I made something, and they're legally supposed to pay me for that. Every dime counts, especially for somebody like me. No. I'm just gonna do these. Beauty companies are just shady. That's why I stopped messing with them. I just order my makeup or shop in, like, Walmart or whatever, Target, and I just, like, I get my makeup there and I just leave. The companies are just not cool anymore. Oh, is Queen here? I didn't see. I suck at this. Well, my brows and going live. Hi, Queen! One of my favorite... Hi, Queen! One of my favorite system songs is Ariel's. After I'm done doing this, I'm going to be like, I don't feel like filming anymore. That happens constantly. I think Mama Blaze went and took a nap. Good. She needs it. She needs her rest. I think that's good enough. Same exact thing here. This brow, because of my thyroid condition, does not grow out to its full length. This one is perfectly fine. This one does not. That's why I shaved them to stubs, because it's just much easier to work with them this way. I gave up completely. So that's why they are the way that they are. Some gel, keep them in place. Aw, I like brows like that. I love Frida Kahlo's eyebrows. Slay. Love it. Love Frida Kahlo's brows. They were her trademark, and she wore them, like, beautifully. I have no motivation to film anymore. This is like me filming. This is, I don't want to do it anymore. Oh, are we at the end of this album already? Ardo is playing. All right, I guess we're just gonna shuffle my whole playlist. Hansel. Oh, Gangrel from WWE. I miss when WWE was WWF and had the Attitude Era going on. I mean, not when they were, like, demeaning to women, but, like, everything else was pretty cool. Wait, we're in the seasons where we don't really have to shave yet. Or anymore. Well, it's still pretty warm where I live. Has the seasons changed? Except at night. At night, it's cooled down tremendously. Which is nice, except for my fibromyalgia is like, bitch, pick weather. Pick which one you want to be. You want to be warm or do you want to be cold? I want it to be cold. Why should I wear a medical mask? I wear masks when not my man, Jeff Hardy. He's in AEW, so if you miss him, watch AEW. Sure, why not? Wasn't sure if I wanted to put anything there, but why not? Why not? Using the Ioni extra large wispy full lashes. Ioni has, like, my favorite lashes of all time. Are these new ones? I guess so. Yep. Which one's left side? Ah! I just got nail glue all over my finger. Great. Love that for me. The Ioni lip oil? I don't think I've tried their lip oil. Maybe I have. Maybe I have. I like the LA Colors lip oil. Super nice lip oil. Yeah, now I've got nail glue. I mean, not nail glue. Lash glue all over my nose. Yeah, I agree. It was nice to see him for a second come back, but I wish they would have kept him around to be feuding with his cousin, with Roman Reigns. It would have been nice to see him tell him off for a little while, except I like John Cena, don't get me wrong, but it would have been nice to see The Rock feuding with him. It would have made more sense than John Cena feuding with him. John Cena had his turn feuding with Roman Reigns when he was still an active wrestler. Rock wasn't actively wrestling with Roman Reigns. And it's his blood relative, so it makes more sense. So it would have been nice. But he's too busy being a Hollywood movie star. Whatever. No, I have not. I don't think. Are they dating? That would be something. Oh, System of a Down came on in Shuffle, but not Toxicity. I won't even say what song is on because it's not fun and not a fun title. They're scamming? Who's scamming? What are they doing? Give me the tea. Oh, thank you so much, honey. Tell me! I don't know if I let the glue dry long enough. Yes, please do. The Rock's in trouble? What? He's in a scandal? What? Usually I'm up to date with that kind of shit, but I guess not. Yeah, it is dead silent in here now. It wasn't silent before. Yes, tell me! Really? I mean, for the other person, I'm not really shocked, but Rocky? I'm not. Really? That's shitty. Rocky! What the hell, dude? My guy! That is not cool. I just, like, you guys don't like any celebrities anymore. They're just disappointing everybody. Every single person. Thank you. I love these lashes. I told you, Ioni lashes are the best. Every celebrity nowadays. Two Halloween songs in a row. Every celebrity or influencer or anybody now is just disappointing left and right. So just don't look up to anybody, you know? I haven't tried their lash glue. I was going to, but I didn't know how it was going to work. So as long as you say their lash glue is good, now I'll know next time I'm at Dollar Tree to pick it up. Thank you for the review. I wasn't sure. I use the Kiss lash glue mostly now. Let me put my straightener on. I'm trying to get things, like, ideas. Oh, okay. Thank you for letting me know. I'm trying to get ideas for Blaze-a-ween videos and for Vlogmas ideas, Blaze-mas videos. Like, I'm trying to write down anything and everything. So far, not much luck. I'm trying to think of things, like, I haven't done before. Because the video I'm getting ready to do is a haul video, but it's a haul from a place I've never hauled from before. Like, really hauled from, especially on my YouTube channel. I did, like, a 3-item haul on my TikTok last year, and I hauled this on my TikTok. So if you are following me on TikTok, you will already have seen all of this. But I thought that this would be a good first Blaze-a-ween video. I already did my first vlog for Blaze-a-ween, but this is my first video for Blaze-a-ween, like my first actual video. Hopefully I'll remember to use my Blaze-a-ween intro video and not my normal intro video, because that was not, like, again, not fun to do. You don't have TikTok? Okay, so this will be a good video for you to watch because it's a haul video and I'm doing it here. Ah! I always mess up with my mascara. They do have the lash glue at my Dollar Tree. I just didn't, I never picked it up because I was like, I don't know how good it's going to be. I don't know what lippy to wear. Is making your iPhone crash? That's strange. Oh, not this. Here's another sneak peek from my first first Jesus Christ, why can't I speak? Blaze-a-ween vlog. Unless you follow me on my other social medias, and you will have already seen that cup everywhere. Please do. I guess my iTunes Shuffle just wants to keep playing System of a Down songs. It's like, yeah, we know we just listen to it, but, like, we still want to listen to System of a Down. Doesn't bother me. I can listen to them 24/7 and not get bored. They better not have. They best not have, or else they're going to start losing a freaking customer. I haven't heard anything about it, and I'm a part of Dollar Tree fan groups on Facebook. That's so sad. But true. Sad, but true. Okay, state taxes. All right, fair. And bag fees. Bag fees, dude, are like, I don't see the point, and I hate it. I hate it here. I hate it when Dollar Tree, I hated it when Dollar Tree added the, now we're doing $1.25 tree. It's free. You are so lucky, Kiwi. Bag fees everywhere. And Walmart doesn't have the option of just regular plastic bags. You have to buy their reusable bags. And their cheapest reusable bag is 89 cents here. And it's like the smallest little freaking bag. So they like make it so you have to buy their bags that are like the most like sensible best bag is like $2. And I'm like, are you kidding me? Seriously? I hate it. I hate it here. And a lot of times when I go to Walmart, I forget to bring my reusable bags. And I'm like, shit, because now I have to buy more reusable bags. I have so many reusable bags now that I don't need. I don't need them. And I have no space for them. Where's my... Oh. We don't have plastic bags for 10 cents at my Walmart. They don't give you that option. Voicemail. If it's important, he'll text me. Everything. Inflation has gotten everything. Inflation has gotten literally everything. When I was in 2018, when my agoraphobia started, everything was it was going up in price a little bit, but not too bad. And then when I came back out in 2001, I went back out in stores and I was like, yay. And then everything freaking changed. And I was like, that's not the price of this. What happened? And I was out with Mama Blaze. She's like, Blaze, inflation happened. Welcome back out into the world. And I'm like, can I just go back inside? I'm like, I can't afford living outside anymore. Can we just go back inside? It was like a shell shock. I was like, what the hell happened out here? Why is it all of a sudden expensive now? And it was just like, what the hell happened? My goodness. It's so song is playing? It's so low. Oh, it's because it's Moonlit Sonata. No. Ooh, the time warp's playing. Just in time for Blaze of Wind to start. We make this louder. I can sing Columbia's part. I know, I won't do it because I don't want to torture you guys. I'm sorry. I won't do that. I shook Tim Curry's hand on Broadway, and I know you guys probably know that, and you're like, Blaze, we know. You've told us the story like 25 times. But I'm never going to stop bragging about that because it's Tim Curry, okay? And he is a legend, and I don't want to hear otherwise. And when he dies, my heart's going to break completely. But he's sticking on to life. Like, he's clinging on, and he's like, yes, bitch, I'm not going to die. Oh, knock on wood. Damn it, I said I wasn't going to do it. No, I said I wasn't going to do Columbia's part, but I'm going to. It's just going to be instinctual because Columbia is like my favorite. Besides Frankenfutter. Obviously. Way before his time. Frankenfutter was way before his time, bitch. Guess I'm going to do Magenta as well. It's getting longer, but like, not fast enough. I think it's just because I keep doing my roots, and so like some hair breaks off, but thank you. Should have never cut it. I shouldn't have cut it, or as cut it as short as I did. Should have maybe just trimmed a little bit, but maybe not cut it as short as it. It was fun for like a couple days, and then I looked in the mirror and I was like, what did I do? I was like, this was not a good idea. But I tried to like just roll with it, and I was like, yeah, this is totally what I wanted. But then I did my hair like style and like, and then I styled it and dyed it and everything. I went to the salon and I was like, I really like this, but I just wish it was longer. Sorry, I had to do Columbia's part. I always do. I can't not. That's definitely something I'll be watching for Blaze of Ween. I can't not watch it. I wanted to be Columbia for Halloween before I started doing Edgar Allan Poe themes. I think I was gonna do it in 2010, but then I was like, oh, money. That's gonna cost a lot of money. And also, I was still insecure with my body, and I was like, I can cover my arms, but not my legs, and not doing that, so. Oh, I had such a nice body in 2010, though. Oh, I hate when I look back at my past and I'm like, why did I think I was fat and ugly then? I was so not. I hate that. I look back at old pictures and I was like, I had a beautiful body and I was so pretty. Why did I think that? I was so stupid. But yes, I do have I have actually two costumes for this year, because I have my Edgar Allan Poe theme this year. I just noticed you can see one of my YouTube short hair now. My favorite, my spirit, Aminal. I don't think we're supposed to say that phrase anymore, but she is. I love Nancy. Nancy is like my favorite person in the entire world. But, yeah, I have a tattoo that I regret, not because it's leopard print. I love leopard print, and I love having obviously, and I love that I have a leopard print tattoo. I hate the tattoo itself, and one day I hope to get it fixed, thanks to my ex-best friend, who, suggested I go to that tattoo artist. He's like, yeah, he's the greatest. He did all my tattoos, and I was like, oh, but your tattoos suck. And maybe I should have like went with that. And I should have been like, girl, his tattoos suck. But I was like, oh, he's my best friend. He wouldn't steer me wrong. And this tattoo guy made me look like I'm Chester the Cheeto guy. And when he was doing it, I saw that he was putting a lot of orange in it. I was like, is it supposed to be that orange? He's like, yeah. It's going to like lighten up in a few days. Didn't. And I started panicking. I was like, what the hell is going on? Didn't. I got this in 2011 or 2012. Yeah. Tattoo regret. Thanks, Josh, you asshole. Should have just stuck with my tattoo artist that I knew from my town that did all my other tattoos. Not saying they were the greatest, but they were better than this shit. My God. So if you guys have any recommendations of videos that you guys want to see, or just like anything that you can think of that I can do for Blazeween or Blazemiss, because like I have like a notebook that I keep ideas in, please let me know, because I'm running dry on ideas. Yeah, I hope to get it fixed one day and touched up, and because I still want the leopard print tattoo. I love leopard print, and I love the way leopard print tattoos look. I just need the shit fixed. And hopefully we won't live in Colorado for the rest of my life. And I want to go back to New Jersey and get a Jersey tattoo, because there are a lot of people in Jersey who do great tattoos. So, or New York even, or Pennsylvania, whatever. East Coast people do great work. Just this one person did not. So, and I also went with him because his name was Corey. And I was like, maybe this is a sign. Girl, you're delusional. Stop it. Wake the hell up. Look at his other work. Why didn't I look at his other work? I did, and it was on Josh, and it looked like shit. So stupid. So gullible. I don't know why I was just like, okay. Because he was my best friend.
I trust you.
Why? Girl, don't trust anybody. Trust the people you went to for your other 4 tattoos. Holy crap, I forgot how many tattoos I had. 4 tattoos. Just stick with those people, or the 2 people that tattooed me, but the same shop. Just stick with the people you know. They didn't do an amazing job, but they did a good job. It's decent. I'm not afraid to show my work that they did. This, I'm like, yeah, cover that up. Let's just cover that up. Let's just pretend that's not there. Gross. Nasty. I just look like a mascot for Cheetos. Or like knockoff Cheetos, like the ones you find in like, what's that store that does like knockoff foods? I forget what it's called. Well, it's in my head and I can't think of it, but the one that does knockoff foods. I'm the knockoff Chester the Cheeto. I'm like Chestette the Cheeto with this bullshit. Look at this bullshit. Look at this. What kind of leopard print is this? What? It's orange and it's just like a block too. It's like not what I showed him. Here, let me see if I can find the picture or something similar to what I showed him, because I'm sure, because I got it in like so long ago, got it like 10 or more years ago. Great value, maybe. Yeah, it is a great value kind of version. Okay, that's close to it, but not as much. Okay, that's close to it too. Okay, this is except up to the neck, go shoulder down pretty much. That's what I asked for. This right here. Ah, That's what I asked for. Okay? Right there. I didn't ask for any coloring or shading in. Just the print itself. And not that one. That was my first tattoo. This is what I got. Huh? What? Stop telling you your age. I'm an 80s baby. I'm a 90s kid. Ooh, Rammstein. I have a love-hate relationship with Rammstein, thanks to my ex-boyfriend. He ruined them for me. But I still love them. So yeah. Tattoo regret. Not because, again, not because it's leopard print. I love Lisa Frank too. Not because it's leopard print. Because of the artist I went to. Please research your tattoo or piercing artist before you go to them. And make sure they have good reviews. Don't just go to them because like a friend is like, yeah, and they have terrible work by them. Look at their work too. And be like, yeah, their shit is gross. Friends are not always trustworthy. Gotta learn that the hard way sometimes. I have to pee, and then I have to film. So I'm going to end this live. Thank you guys for joining. Thank you, Kiwi. Thank you, Queen. Thank you, Pink. Thank you, all of you, for joining me. I really, really appreciated it. I needed this. It was cathartic, and I love talking to you guys. I did the top. My piercing just started. I re-pierced so many and pierced so many of this. And Corey, he had a whole piercing kit. And he pierced this. And he pierced my cartilage. And then I gauged my cartilage right here. Don't gauge your cartilage, please. It's stupid. I was bored and I don't mind certain pains. Please don't do what I did. But yeah, Corey, he spent some time in a tattoo shop and a piercing shop. So he was just like, here, we were bored one night and he just pierced two holes in my ears. And I just re-pierced existing piercings in my ear. So I've re-pierced my ears many times, but like I haven't needed to in years. So anyway, thank you guys so much for hanging out with me. I really needed this. And now I'm going to go pee and drink some water. And then I'm going to go film. And I'll be filming more in my vlog. Hope you guys are having a great day and having a good fall so far. It's finally fall. We will have some good Blazeween. If you guys have any recommendations, please leave them down in the comments. I really need some. I have one idea. And I have to see how I'm going to go about it and like layout, do the layout of it and everything and not make it a million hours long and everything. And I'll speak to you guys soon. Until next time, my wicked ones. Stay wicked. Love you.